what God has for us. So much to look forward to on Thanksgiving, one of our holidays, as we call it, but we know that it can be a difficult time for some in one way or another, and yet we know that God has a plate, so to speak, laid out for you, and if you can receive this. And it has its own way. Everybody has their own palate. That means what they eat, and you know, everybody can't eat this and that. But this is something that the scripture says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. He writes, "Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." Now, to be forthright, he's talking to those who are believers. Yes, to believers, those who people might think is upbeat all the time, have everything in one, don't worry about what they don't have. But you know, even as Christians, we can run into those moments, those times, those seasons in our life where we're not always rejoicing. We're not always praying. And sometimes we're not always giving thanks. But when we think about the goodness of God, we should be able to do just these things. Rejoice in the Lord when you holler and you shout. It just means that in your soul, in your heart, there's a deep-seated contentment that enables you to just rejoice. It means to have joy. It means to not have to wait till the Christmas season to sing Christmas song. It just means, however, it's an abiding satisfaction that you have. And then he says, after that, pray without ceasing. And again, this is how we make it. What do you mean you make it? This is how we make it through our seasons. This is the season now. It's fall, you know, and then you have winter and spring and summer. That's a cyclical thing that happens in terms of our way things are made up in the periphery. But life is like that also. But you don't have to have your life be pinned to a seasonal, cyclical kind of thing where you can only have joy at this time. You can only have peace at this time. You can only pray when things are not going well. But God wants us to know that these are for you year round. And so if you're right now struggling with things on your mind, your uncertainty, this is a good time to take God up at his word. And he says this, and everything give thanks. And then you say, well, you don't know what's going on right now. And everything give thanks. Does that mean God is disregarding what struggles you might be having in your life? What has happened? What you were thinking about? Is troubling you? No, and everything give thanks. For this is the word of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. In other words, God, I'm not talking to anybody else. I'm talking to you. And he's not talking to you in a stern manner. He's talking to you with a father's hand outstretched, knowing that this is good for you to give thanks. Just think about it. Just let something run up from your mind. The Spirit of God inside of you will start that upsurge of thanksgiving coming in your heart. And God will cause us to remember. He causes us, he'll bring back to our attention. Most importantly, the fact that Jesus is ours and we are his. That will cause thanks to come up in your heart and your life. And so we just want to take a moment.